In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends in Jesus Christ, today, through this gospel passage, is inviting us to love God and to love our neighbors also. St. John says, when you say that I love God and you hate your fellow brothers and sisters, you are a liar. So remember the times in our life where we failed to love our neighbors. Feel sorry for the times and ask God to forgive our sins. To participate worthily in this Holy Mass, let us acknowledge our shortcomings and sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Draw near to our servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness. For those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
For the first reading, please take page number 989 of the Old Testament. The first reading is taken from the book of prophet Ezekiel, chapter 43, verses 1 to 7, on page number 989 of the Old Testament. The angel brought me to the gate facing the east. And behold, the glory of God of Israel came from the east, and the sound of his coming was like the sound of many waters, and the earth shone with his glory. And the vision I saw was like the vision which I had seen when he came to destroy the city, and like the vision which I had seen by the river Chebar. And I fell upon my face as the glory of the Lord entered the temple by the gate facing the east. The Spirit lifted me up and brought me into the inner court. And behold, the glory of the Lord filled the temple. While the man was standing beside me, I heard one speaking to me out of the temple. And he said to me, "Son of man, this is the place of my throne and the place of the soles of my feet, where I will dwell in the midst of the people of Israel forever. The word of the Lord. Our responsory psalm is taken from Psalm 85, and the verses are from 9 to 14, and our response to the psalm. The glory of the Lord will dwell in our land. The glory of the Lord will dwell in our land. I will hear what the Lord God has to say, a voice that speaks of peace. Peace for his people and his friends. His help is near for those who fear him, and his glory will dwell in our land. Our response? The glory of the Lord will dwell in our land. Mercy and faithfulness have met. Justice and peace have embraced. Faithfulness shall spring from the earth, and justice look down from heaven. Our response? The glory of the Lord will dwell in our land. The Lord will make us prosper, and the earth shall yield its fruit. Justice shall march before him, and peace shall follow his steps. Our response? The glory of the Lord will dwell in our land. Acclamation.
Sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia. Sing alleluia. Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Your precepts, O Lord, are all of them sure. They stand firm forever and ever.
Sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia.
Sing alleluia. Sing alleluia to the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 23, verses 1 to 12. Jesus said to the crowds and to his disciples, "The scribes and the Pharisees sit on Moses' seat, so practice and observe whatever they tell you, but not what they do. For they preach, but do not practice. They bind heavy burdens, hard to bear, and lay them on men's shoulders, but they themselves will not move them with their finger. They do all their deeds to be seen by men. And they love the place of honor at the feast and the best seats in the synagogues and the solutions in the marketplaces, being called Rabbi by men. But you are not to be called Rabbi, for you have one teacher and you are all brothers. And call no man your father on earth, for you have one father who is in heaven. Neither be called master, for you have one master, the Christ. He who is greatest among you shall be your servant. Whoever exalts himself will be humbled, and whoever humbles himself will be exalted." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends in Jesus Christ, once a pastor, he was addressing to the crowd, and he was telling that how to overcome the temptations, he was telling. So among the crowd, there is his wife also sitting and listening what he was preaching. And he said, One of the way you can avoid the temptations, you tell to our wives not to keep onions in the curry. So very nicely that his wife also heard that what he said, what he was preaching. Then after homily, the man went to, the pastor went to the home, and the lady, his wife, did not keep the onions in the curry. Then this man asked, he called her and asked, why you did not keep onions in the curry? She said, you only told that how to avoid the temptations in order, don't keep, you said, that's why I did not keep curry, in the curry, onions, he said. Then the pastor, he told that in Telugu, Epichidana, it is not meant for us, it is only meant for the people. Which means, whatever we preach, we don't practice. And you expect others to practice. That's what in today's gospel we see. Here, today's gospel is an interesting passage for all those who want to imitate Christ. Don't think this is only meant for referring only Pharisees and scribes. It is also relevant to us also. It is about our love of God and love of neighbor. And Jesus is telling, teaching the disciples two things. To find the ways, what are the two things? To love and to serve. That's why in today's gospel Jesus says, who is the greatest man among you? Jesus is asking, which means to be servant. We are called to be served, not to be served. Whatever Jesus preached, he practiced in his life. For example, we can take the Holy Thursday. Jesus is showing that washing at the feet of disciples, whatever he preached, he was showing in actions. In today's gospel, Jesus is denouncing the actions of the Pharisees and scribes. And Jesus is telling us to learn the faith of Christ. What is the faith of Christ? It is nothing but is the love and serve all. This is the faith. But Jesus is not criticizing the faith of the scribes and Pharisees in today's gospel. He is asking us, whatever you preach, first you practice. Until unless you practice, you can't tell to the people to practice it. That's what the message we get from today's gospel. So remember the times, most of where we failed to practice whatever we read from Bible. We failed many times. Feel sorry for that. And ask God the grace that He may give us the grace to look into our life so that we may modify our thoughts and our actions. May God bless you all.
Breads and wine we bring to you, Lord, work of the hands of man, soon to become your body and blood, Jesus your Son. Take our waste, all that we have and all that we do, we give to you, all for you, our Savior and our God. Blessed
Lord of all creation, for through goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of wine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, we ask God be pleasing to you. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept his sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice. Make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks for most holy, through your beloved Son Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as your Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling our will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare our glory as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy God, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we bring by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and bread of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis of Pope, Antumma Bala, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, you have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Antoniamma, Amalamma, Romy Fernandez, Antumani Paul, R.K. Das, All Souls in Purgatory, Javier Francis, R.A.K. Swami, R.A.K. Mary, Javier Francis. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, shall we pray, that with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints we have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, O Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespassing against us. And lead us not temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Be healing the body. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
Only say the words,
and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ, may the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. Amen.
Make me a servant, humble and meek. Lord, let me lift up those who are weak. And may the prayer of my heart always be. Make me a servant, make me a servant, make me a servant today. Let me lift up those who are
prayer of my heart always be, make me a servant, make me a servant, make me a servant today.
Christi, soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, heal me. Within your wounds, hide me. Suffer me not to be separated from you. From the malignant enemy, defend me. At the hour of my death, call me and bid me come to you. That with your sins I may praise you for all eternity. Amen. For the intentions of our Holy Father, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Let us pray. May the communion in our sacrament, that what we have received, save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hymn number 485.
Holy Queen, we bend before thee, Queen of purity divine. Keep us free from sin, we pray.